everyone, this is Doxy Mom, and welcome back to my channel. If you haven't done so already, I greatly appreciate if you hit that little red subscribe button. You can ring the bell for notifications, and if you like this video, just give it a thumbs up. Well, Miss Cindy and I, we're here to bring you the news in 15 minutes or less, so let's get started. Now, Jennifer Mack, she released a video on Sunday talking about shared identities, and she found something very interesting that I want to share with y'all. Now, if you've been following the theory that John F. Kennedy Jr. is alive, and I even made a video on a theory of how he could have faked his death. It's called JFK Jr., Could He Be Alive? And I'll link that down in the pinned comments. Anyway, y'all all have heard of 107, which sounds like 107, which equals 17 when you drop the zero, which equals Q. I wanted to kind of write that out for you and kind of give you a visual. Now, Juan, you know, he calls into different shows like Jennifer Mack and Ann Vandersteel over at Steel Truth, which I love both those ladies. Anyway, in Jennifer's latest video, which I'll link in the pinned comment, and I'll show you a screenshot here in just a minute, but it shows a picture in an old Peebles magazine of a note that JFK Jr., he wrote it, and he signed it, Juan, and there are pictures of the envelope with the return address as Juan Kennedy. See if you guys can see that. So like I said, I will link this video, but isn't that interesting? Now, I know many people do not think that Juan is Junior, but if you really listen to the information that Juan gives, especially in his old interviews with Field McConnell, guys, Juan just knows things. Oftentimes, it just seems like he knows insider information. When he talks, he sometimes uses the word, "We did this." So, with what Jennifer just found, it just really seems like to me that 107 very much could be JFK Jr., but you're going to have to decide for yourself, and I will leave a link. Now, Fox News is reporting that General Flynn's case will be heard again on August the 11th in front of the full Court of Appeals. Now, remember, the DOJ dropped General Flynn's case, but the evil deep state, Judge Sullivan, he just wanted to play judge and prosecutor, and he wouldn't drop it. So, it went to a 3-panel judge at the Court of Appeals, and they ruled 2-1 to drop the charges against General Flynn. Well, Judge Sullivan, he wasn't having that. So, here we are now going in front of the entire Court of Appeals. Now, Flynn's lawyer, Sidney Powell, she says that Judge Sullivan's actions are unconstitutional because it's not his job to appeal. He's supposed to be like the neutral umpire. The neutral umpire, if I can talk today, and the Court of Appeals, they shouldn't have allowed this in the first place. Now, the exculpatory evidence was hidden from Flynn and Powell, not to mention they told General Flynn they would go after his son if he didn't plead guilty. Now, General Flynn, he was set up, he was extorted, and then they just keep bringing this up and dragging it out. KT McFarland, she thinks they're trying to string this along until after the election because they think that a Democrat will be elected and then they can really go after General Flynn. But that's not going to happen, y'all. Now, the American justice system is blackmailing and extorting patriotic Americans. And guys, this must stop. So, continue to pray for General Flynn, President Trump and his family, 17 in the team, military and their families, and all those fighting for this country and the world. And I will keep you posted, and I will leave a link. Now, Susan St. James tweeted this out. The ratings have crashed for Major League Baseball and the NBA. It turns out the American people don't take kindly to disrespecting our flag in tweet. And she's absolutely right. And guys, between not allowing fans into the stadium to nobody watching the games and the commercials on television, well, they're going to lose millions. And personally, I have never understood why professional athletes deserve to make millions of dollars a year just for playing a game. Now, the Bradford File, they tweeted this out. Sweden flattened their curve with no lockdowns, and they didn't destroy their economy. And Bridget Gabriel tweeted this. This election is not Republican versus Democrat. It's patriotism versus tyranny. It's freedom versus socialism. It's law and order versus anarchy. End tweet. And guys, she is absolutely right. We need good patriots in our government. So if you feel that God is leading you into a leadership position, well, you need to get in the race, okay? Then Matt Couch, he tweeted this. There is no way Trump is trailing by 7 points in Florida. Chris Wallace is laughable. End tweet. Guys, whenever I hear about polls, I automatically think back to the 2016 election. And I know I was a little late to the game, but the night of the 2016 election is when I finally realized that the media was lying to us all along. So I don't trust polls, and I certainly don't trust the mainstream media, and I'll link my Twitter page. Next, the Gateway Pundit. They're reporting that there is more than enough evidence for the American public to demand an audit on the legitimacy of the coronavirus numbers. There have been hundreds, if not thousands, of fraudulent cases. And we all know why the CDC demanded America's doctors count even suspect cases, because they want people scared. A 33-year-old nurse, Danielle DeCenso, unfortunately, she passed away in March. She died suddenly in her sleep. They listed it as COVID, but she died of a kidney infection. And in Oregon this week, a 26-year-old man, Matthew Irvin, he was listed as the youngest person to die of COVID, and COVID-19 was put on his death certificate. Well, he didn't have COVID either. And I've heard so many stories like these, but guys, I doubt we'll ever know the truth, since they've just messed with the numbers since the very beginning. Now, just don't fear, okay? Put your faith in the Lord, and I will link the two Gateway pundits. But guys, please, please do not fear. Now, Fox Business, they're reporting that the White House and the Democrats are very far apart on a new stimulus package. The deadlock seems to be on the enhanced unemployment benefits that expired last week. Now, Representative Greg Stube, he went on Fox Business and said the sides are still very far apart. Democrats, well, of course they want to extend the unfair $600 a week, because by them keeping that extra money, well, that's keeping people from getting back into the workforce, because they're making more money just sitting home doing nothing. And this must stop. So who knows what will happen, because how do you work with evil people like Pelosi and Schumer? And the interviewer, she made a statement about how Republicans kind of waited to the last minute before working on this. Well, hello, things have been a little crazy and chaotic with riots and autonomous zones and statues being torn down and buildings being burnt. It's not like President Trump's been out on the golf course every day playing a game, but you know what? He could have been. It was his choice to get in this fight. Guys, he fights every single day for you, for me, for the American people, for the world. And what does he get for it? A bunch of bashing for 3.5 years. But we all know God is shielding our wonderful president, and all this chaos is temporary. And I know that I really can't wait until Christmas. So I'll leave a link, and I'm going to leave you with 2 Thessalonians chapter 3. Verses 1 through 5 that say, "As for other matters, brothers and sisters, pray for us that the message of the Lord may spread rapidly and be honored just as it is with you, and pray that we may be delivered from wicked and evil people, for not everyone has faith. But the Lord is faithful, and he will strengthen you and protect you from the evil one. We have confidence in the Lord that you are doing and will continue to do the things we command. May the Lord direct your hearts into God's love and Christ's perseverance. Well, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for tuning in. Until next time, this is Doxy Mom, and God bless you all.